G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week I've got this false color infrared effect for you in Affinity photo. It creates this surreal looking landscape. So as usual, let's get started. We're going to use this photo here, and both the photos that I'm going to use today are from Unsplash and they will be linked below. So the first thing we're going to do on our background here is Command J to duplicate this picture here. What we want to do first is invert this picture, sort of make it like a negative, and you can come up here to layer invert, or we can use our shortcut, which is Command I to invert the picture, and that gives us this negative looking photograph. Next thing we're going to do is on our blend modes, we're going to change our blend mode to color, and it changes that to a sort of a purpley looking picture, but we want to make it more of an infrared picture. So we're going to add an adjustment layer, and we're going to come down and add a channel mixer. And what we're going to do now is reverse our red and blue channels. So we're going to start off on our red channel here, and we're going to change the percentage here to 0 and hit enter. And then on our blues here, we're going to change that to 100 and hit enter. Starting to get sort of our infrared, but we need to come down here to our blue channel and do the reverse again. On our blue channel, we're going to make the percentage 100, and on our blue down here, we're going to change that to 0. So basically what we have done is just swap the blue and red channels. We've left all the other colors in place, like the sky and the clouds, and we've targeted the green. So everything that was green has gone to this sort of infrared pink look. So we'll click off our channel mixer here. So the next thing we'll do is just add a HSL adjustment as well. This is going to be a very subtle adjustment. And we're going to target our red. So click on the reds here. And we're just going to bring that up tiny little bit. And then we can play with our saturation. You can bring your saturation up as much as you want. I'm just going to bring it up a tiny little bit about there, very subtle. And there we go, everybody. That's the false color infrared effect in Affinity Photo. Very easy to achieve in just a few short steps. But let's make the photo a little bit more interesting. Let's come over to this photo here of the three planets. Let's copy that with a Command C and come back to our picture here and Command V. Come over here to our Move tool and let's just resize those planets. And I'm going to turn them around. I'm going to rotate them all the way around. I'm holding my shift key down as well just so I can snap those into place and keep them straight. Going to change the blend mode on the planets to screen, and then I'm going to make them quite big and sit them right up on top here. And to blend these planets in a little bit better, I'm going to use the blend ranges here, this little cogwheel up here. So make sure you're on the planets background. Click on the blend ranges. So I'm just going to use this side, this graph today, underlying composition ranges, and it's going to do exactly that. When I bring this slider down, it's going to bring the underlying image forward or to the front of our planets here, and it just makes it look like those clouds now are in front of the planets. If you want to learn a little bit more about blend ranges and blend options, there's a really good tutorial by James Ritson from Affinity Photo. I'll pop that on the screen now, and I'll also link that video below. It is well worth a watch if you're interested in learning a little bit more about blend ranges. Okay, let's click off that, and on our planets layer here, I'm just going to add another adjustment, another HSL adjustment. I'm going to clip that to the planets layer so it only affects the planets. Just targeting the reds again, and I'm just going to bring that up a little bit so we can get a bit of a closer color to our landscape, maybe a little bit more saturation, and that's probably looking a little bit closer to the color of our landscape. And I'm going to add one more adjustment down here, which is going to be our curves adjustment right on top here. Going to move this one, this little node up tiny little bit to flatten the blacks, a little bit darker, and create that S curve as usual. On our planets here, I might just drop that opacity on the planets down a little bit to about 75%. And there we go, everybody. That is my tutorial on that false color infrared effect in Affinity Photo. We've added the three planets to make the picture look a little bit more interesting with that really surreal landscape. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay safe, stay well, and I'll see you in my next video.